Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome aboard this PMDG 747 flight from Nadi, the Fiji Islands, over to Changi in Singapore. Flight time probably around 9 to 10 hours. The purpose of this flight today is to show you some en route things, and most of the events are going to be taking place when we land and when we start to descend into the Singapore airspace because of the weather over there. It's currently monsoon season and the weather is not very nice. So, en route, we will occasionally look at the METAR and adjust our flight accordingly. I'm also going to be using a Route 2 in the FMC to have an alternate programmed. The weather here is not too bad. We're going to tune into the ATIS in just a moment to verify that the wind is still in the right direction for a takeoff on runway 20. It should be. The reason for that is, well, I'm hoping it is, well, two reasons. One, it should be because there's no wind, so we can use any runway we want. We'll take runway 20, thank you. And second, it is the longest, so I can't imagine the wind having changed in the last sort of 2 or 3 minutes from when I just listened to it a moment ago to when I started, when I welcomed you on board. Having a quick look at the instruments, you can see that the primary flight display is set up as it always is. Our pressure setting is currently 29.85. So we've got slightly low pressure from 2992. V speeds are all set, and the indicated airspeed is set at V2, 176. I'll show you the flight management computer in just a moment. Initial climb altitude of 5,000 feet. I've set 1,600 feet per minute for the climb, so we can hand over to the vertical speed to climb us out. For the departure route itself, I've programmed myself, and I'll show you how I did that. And because of the tight turn required, and we're quite a heavy aircraft, you can see we've got 264,000 pounds, so we're quite heavy today, full load. I'll explain why the APU is running if you're thinking about that right now in just a moment. And because of this big right turn here, I want to not use LNAV, so I'm using a heading hold, runway heading. And I'll explain the departure in just a moment. So we've got the bank limiter set at 15 degrees and we're not going to be using RNAV or VNAV on the climb out until we're actually on our way. So on the navigation display, having moved across from here, this is all set up as it should be. Navigation display, we've got the VOR, the right VOR tuned into the Nadi VOR, and I've also pressed the position button here just to give us a sort of a running commentary, if you like, on where we are in terms of VOR radial, should we have to turn back or anything like that. It's just nice to know what radial we're on. Something I haven't really said enough in my other videos, and it occurred to me just now actually, is that orientation really is probably the third most important thing after altitude and airspeed. Where you are, orientation. We're going to have to be using we're going to have to be very orientated on this particular flight as we come into Changi because of the weather and the potential of diversions or missed approach. So we really do need to be aware of where we are at all times. So I just thought it'd be quite a nice idea to, for once, put the position indicator on the navigation display just to give us a running commentary of what radial we're on at all times from that VOR. That's quite nice. Now the route I'll explain in just a moment. Otherwise we've got runway heading set 204 ish taking us out to this point here, which is actually an NDB, and the NDB is selected here. If we look at the bottom left, it's tuned in over here rather than the VOR. We've got the ADF tuned in. I'll keep the zoom at 20. Over to this side, we're using max power for takeoff, flaps 20 for a shorter takeoff run. Whilst it's the longest runway we're using, it's still not the longest in the world, and we're very, very heavy, and at the end of the runway is a lot of trees and a lot of water, so I want to be up as quickly as possible. Now, APU running, why is that? What I'm going to do today is something I've never done before, which is an APU to PAX takeoff. I'll show you a synopsis of the navigation display. What am I doing? Wrong one, ICAS. Here is the PAX system, ECS, I've selected on the ICAS options. And you can see that the APU is currently going into PAC 2. Now what we're going to do on takeoff is at the moment, we're going to turn off pack 1 and pack 3 just before takeoff, first of all. But at the moment, the isolation valve left and right is closed, so the APU is feeding pack 2. So there is something going into the system. Now, the APU does provide the bleed air required, but only up until 15,000 feet, and it can't be started in air once it's been turned off. So the APU I've left running from engine start, so it hasn't actually been turned off at all, and the APU bleed air has been opened. I could, of course, turn it off like that, but it's turned on like that. And just before we take off, packs 1 and 3 will be switched off, and we'll just be running off the APU. You can still hear the air conditioning unit running in the background, whereas if I turn that off, then we lose it all. See? We don't want that to happen. So it's all running right now from engines 1, 2, 3, 4 going into the various parts of the system, etc. Once we take off, we'll turn on one of the packs, and once we a few moments later, I'll explain that once we're flying, I'll turn on the third pack, and then we'll open the isolation valves and turn off the APU. So the reason I'm doing that is because it's a short runway and we need to get a good bit of climb, and just having that extra bit of power is useful. It's not really going to change the performance greatly, but I'm just doing it as a matter of course to demonstrate the fact that it's possible to do that, rather than it's actually going to make any difference to the flight, to be quite honest with you. Everything else on the overhead panel is set as we need. I'm going to turn on the taxi light. It's actually on already, so we'll start taxiing in just a moment. I'll show you the charts and we will be away. The first chart is going to be of the Nadi ground and a few rules. Here's the ground map. This is where we are parking at the moment, over here on the Alpha area. We're going to be lining up on via Alpha onto runway 20. Hopefully get a rolling start onto the runway. We should be up about here. Now over here on this page, jet noise abatement climb procedures apply to runway 20. That's us. So let's have a little look at that. Climb them at V2 plus 10 knots to V2 plus 20. My indicated airspeed is currently set to V2, so I'm going to pass that by 10 knots as per this, because we can. Maybe about 200 feet above ground level. Maintain takeoff power to a height above the aerodrome of 1500 feet. I will show you that in the FMC I have selected the power reduction altitude in the VNAV to be at 1500, but that would be only if I'm climbing in VNAV mode. I suppose I will actually apply VNAV. It's the lateral navigation that I want to do manually, so I'll probably arm VNAV and we'll have a power reduction as per the regulations at 1500 feet. Then reduce thrust to climb power, blah blah blah, that's all fine, up to 3000, marvellous. Accelerate to en route climb speed with flap retraction on schedule. Maintain 2500 feet on runway track unless required to do otherwise in accordance with this SID or ATC instruction. So we can kind of ignore part E in a way. But we're climbing out to, well, I'm going to show you the SID in just a moment. We're climbing out, I think, to about 2,500 feet anyway, so that is okay. Now the actual standard instrument departure is here. Here is the Bravo departure. Runway 20 requires us to fly straight out to the NDB. We can read it over here actually. Maintain runway track to 2,500. Turn right to intercept 320 bearing from Alpha Lima. That's my NDB tuned in. Climbing to minimum set heading altitude 3000. Well, we've set 5000. And according to the FMC, we'll be at 3,500 or something by this point, so that's okay. After this, we'll be going out to INTID. Then, I'll show you in the FMC right now, that we have after INTID, Taver Legot, and 4 pages worth of waypoints up to Nimitz, which is just outside our destination. I don't know what runway we're going to be using, I don't know what arrival we're going to be using, because we're going to be following the weather changes and the wind changes, so I can't put an arrival in yet. We'll do that en route and see what happens. I'll show you that on the plan view. So we're starting here. This is our departure, big right turn, out to INTID, which was on that chart, over here. And the route's pretty much taking us out in a straight line. Bit of a left turn at Hotel November. crossing along the islands there, just north of Australia. So a bit left and right, and then working our way into the Singapore area over here. So that's all jolly marvellous. That recommends up to flight level 390 will be our step climb. Optimum flight level, it says flight level 330. I've put 310. We'll look at that again in once we're actually up to sort of 25,000 feet and see if we need to revise that anymore. Expecting to land with 28,400 of fuel, which is good because we might need to divert or go around even twice. And I set the minimums to 15, I think. 16. Set them to 16. So we shouldn't be going below minimums if we're two go-arounds and a divert. That should be okay. Okay, so there's a VNAV page. Transition altitude, by the way, is 11,000 for this area, which means we're using altitudes up until 11,000, and then we're onto the flight levels at flight level 130. Cute's on the next page. Everything is looking good. The taxi light was on. For the centre pedestal, auto brakes are RTO, no smoking, seat belts on and on. Trims are all neutral. The TCAS is set to TA. After takeoff, that will go to TARA, of course. Now, let's have a quick listen to the ATIS, which was 127.8. Well, that was us to use runway 2, which has changed, but to be honest, I'm going to ignore that, and we're going to we'll say that we've requested runway 20, but because of our size and our weight and our route, that would absolutely be granted, considering it's a very, very unbusy airport. Okay. So the wind is pretty much nothing, and it's absolutely not a problem for us to go up on runway 20. Well, keep a good eye on the navigation display TCAS for any aircraft that might be floating around the area, but we can see that there aren't none. So again, not a problem. I'd like a rolling takeoff, so I'll hold short of the runway just to verify everything once more, very, very quickly. And we'll just take a rolling takeoff. Okay, throttle closed, coming to a stop. There's no need to use the brakes when not necessary. Ground roll, stop, parking, brake set. Have a quick look at the lights. Turn on the landing lights now. Off with the taxi, on with the strobe. Now, pack one. I'll let you see what's happening. Let's press the wrong button. Pack one, off. Pack three, off. Pack two being fed from the APU. APU is running. Strobes are on. Our route said up to 2,500. We'll do our best to reach that. Okay. I'll bring up the primary flight display and the ICAS once we're lined up on the runway, as always. will line up under 10 knots. How about now? We want symmetrical thrust, so we don't apply full power until we're straight. Toga. Airspeed is active. So we're going to hold 176 just after takeoff, and then we're going to just touch the nose down and climb at V2 plus 10, so 186. There's the ADF just kicked in.
V1.
Go.
Rotate. V2.
Alright, got a positive climb on the altimeter. Gear up. Thrust ref. Flight director's just centralising itself there. And VNAV. Also heading hold 205. Flaps 10. Climb power at 1500. Now I don't want to use LNAV because the turn is going to be too steep. We're currently one away, we can go ahead with the heading hold now, and the heading is going to be just to follow the magenta line, which will intercept the 320 radial from this NDB. Flaps 5. Now we've got climb power, and that is when we are to turn on pack 1. That's one. I'm going to just into. I'm just going to disable set the vertical speed myself by disabling the vertical navigation. 275 will accept, as we're a heavy aircraft and we don't want to be going at slow speeds, very low to the ground. And the flaps are up. I've increased the rate of bank there to 20 degrees. We'll just continue that turn to the right to intercept the line. Obviously we'll be over to the area now, area controller, who would give us clearance above 5,000 since we're such a big aircraft. We'll climb up to 9,000 now. 9,000, gear handle off. That's coming back for a 275 hold. You can see on the navigation display that the radial is now changing to 203, 204 as we go round that NDB. I slightly underestimated the turn required for our weight. But either way, we're still flying out to that waypoint. So it could be worse. And in just a moment I'll engage LNAV. Now that we don't need any bank limit. It's 5,000 feet. Pack 3. APU bleed off. Isolation valves are now open. The APU can go off. And up we go. Nice view out the window there. You can just see the airport off to the right. over to LNAV for the intercept. We'll accept a clearance up to flight level 150. TARA from TCAS. There we go. APU's just shut down. Marvellous. We'll turn off that NDB beacon. The ADF. Get the VOR tuned in just for orientation purposes, currently on the 267 268 radial, 10 nautical miles away. And LNAV intercepted well. Now we're on course, we'll just verify the VNAV page before I engage VNAV once again. It's going to hold 276, and at 10,000 it will accelerate up to 328. So having just seen our altitude just approaching 9,000, I'll wait until we pass 10,000. Then I'll enable VNAV to take us up to 328. The most economical way to fly these larger aircraft is to get up to your cruise altitude as quickly as possible. So I'm going to try to make that happen by not levelling out all the way up. 600 to go. I'll bring up the VNAV page so you can see what happens to this speed transition. Gone. Over to VNAV, up to 328 knots. That's going to use max climb power, 147. Outboard landing light off. Inboard landing light off. Passed our transition there of 11,000, so in just a moment that's going to tell us to have to change. That normally happens 18,000 in the default because no one ever changes the transition altitude like it's just done there, you see. Normally that happens at 18,000. You can change it. VNAV pitching us up there to hold 328 knots. I'll lift that restriction from 15 and we'll put it up to 24,000 now and press the button. And that's giving us a very, very good climb rate. Lovely view of the islands. Go to your intercept. It's going to bring the climb power back to climb 1 now. It's giving us 1.51 down to 1.34. And once the nose has settled with that reduced power setting, I shall turn off the seatbelts. Looking good, giving us 2,000 feet per minute. Rate of climb. 40 nautical miles from the Nadi VOR and 60 until Inted. If we look at the legs page, we can see what altitude it recommends, it thinks we'll be at. That says 30,000. It's looking good. We'll put a cruise altitude of 33,000. We can see that that's going to work for us. Okay, marvellous. Excellent climb performance, D747. We'll go up now to 270. Now that indicated airspeed of 328 is going to be held until we get to 0.782, which is approaching. So once that happens, this will show 0.782. The aircraft will pitch to and keep the same power to maintain 0.782. And as we continue climbing, that means our indicated airspeed will start to reduce. Three to go. Speed transition coming up. We'll probably be using a long range cruise, or I'll show you how increasing the cost index increases our cruise speed, and we'll modify our actual arrival fuel and time. The indicated airspeed just changed there to the Mach number, 0.782. The VNAV is now going to follow that, and we'll slowly watch our indicated airspeed drop as we climb. I'll increase the altitude now to flight level 330 for our cruise. Hit a bit of turbulence. The wind is chucking us around a little bit. I'm just thinking about whether I should put the seatbelt sign on. We'll just see how it goes. VNAV's doing its best to hold the speed, but it does jump around quite a lot. Only 5,000 to go to that cruise altitude. We should be out of the worst of the bad weather here. Go till INTED, approaching 30,000, 3,000 to go. VNAV doing its best. Quickly. Just passed over the INTED waypoint on our way now to Taver, 234 to go. VNAV path